work, honestly.
So Jolene, I mean, if we don't mind taking a second to do it, or when we get ready to take a break, sometimes people just get out and they come back in.
Okay.
But you don't have to do that right this second if you want to listen, but we can wait if you want to try. If okay. Tanya, only if you have time, because
yeah,
I don't
know. Of course I do. At. Yeah, of course I do.
Maybe people can take a quick stretch.
And I'm trying to fix the connection. I don't know.
Still here. That's why it makes me think it's something quirky, like a button that got pushed or something got clicked on. But that window is there in the background because you're still connected to us.
Right. Yep. I can hear everybody just fine.
Yeah. It's just hard to help when we can't see what you're looking at ourselves. When you move your mouse around your screen, there's no, does the Zoom toolbar come up or anything?
Wait, I'm pushing a desktop. Let's see. Join a meeting without signing in. Yes.
Well, you're that, already
it
joined.
Just pops back on again.
Okay, is it up now?
No, I'm not. It's it's saying enter the meeting ID number. I don't know. All these things are going up.
Big mystery. So if you want to try, as long as you have the link to come back and revisit, if you want to try just closing out of everything and then coming back in, sometimes that works when people have snafus. But they usually get completely kicked out, and that's why they have to come back in. So I don't know what will happen.
Do folks want to take a 5-minute break? Stretch your legs, get some water, Quentin. I'm looking at Quentin. He's nodding his head. I'm going to take that as a everybody would like to take a break.
Oh, sorry, guys.
Smiling.
I can't go on here.
That's okay.
That's right. We probably all need to stretch our legs anyway. We've all been sitting.
Yeah, we don't want to lose you. We want you to be able to see, because sometimes it's hard to understand when things are being explained if you don't have a visual.
And you know what, Jolene? I can take you in a chat room and have you share your screen and see if that might help.
That's a really good idea, but how's she going to share her screen if she can't find the toolbar to share her screen?
Oh, that's a good point, Lori.
Because I was thinking myself, if only we could see her screen.
Okay, it's asking me, what device are you trying to update or install Zoom on?
You already must have it because you were active.
Right, I'm on the laptop.
Let stay right there. Let me see if I can just re-invite you and then you can come in through a new link.
Okay.
Good idea.
It's saying this page can't be displayed.
Okay.
Again.
Let me go to my email and I'm going to just make sure I have yours.
I will be right back.
Go ahead, Lori.
I'll be right here.
All right, let me see. Just this one. I just want to make sure I have your right email, Jolene. If it says Jolene on it,
yep.
I'll be able to pick it up. So it should
be jolenekuhn@gmail.com.
Okay. So tell it to me again. I'm just going to resend this to you.
jolenekuhn@gmail.com.
And it's all one word?
Yes.
@gmail.com. All right. All right. So I just sent it. Let me know when you get it.
Okay.
And then when you get it, you can move on. You can end your meeting.
Yeah, Dee came in at 3, so she, I guess, was trying, but then she has a cook. Huh?
Have you gotten it yet?
Wait a minute. I think I found you.
There okay. You are. All right. Perfect. All right. Oh, so yeah. You're in.
Yes. Thank you. Thank you.
You're welcome. She's back. Oh, my goodness. If you need to stretch, Jolene, you should stretch.
I'm good. Wow, it's 20 after 6. Holy moly.
How did you figure it out?
I have no idea. I just, went to X out, and then I saw Tanya's face. Here you are. And then I saw you up top, so I just clicked on you, and whoop, there you were. But actually, all my icons are over here on the side, which weren't there before. But that's okay. I'm not going to touch anything.
Right? Seriously.
Get alone. Do you see me?
We see something that says Jolene, because I don't know if your camera's off. You might have to turn your camera on.
Oh.
Start video.
Oh, wait a minute. Oh, yeah. Start video. Yep. Mm-hmm. Oh, no, Zoom is unable to detect a camera.
Okay. That's,
okay. But you can see us?
I can see you, yep.
Okay.
Yep.
That's half the battle.
Yeah.
There we go. All right. And I'm just going and finding anyone who sent me a Gmail. I'm just taking advantage of the break to send them another invitation. So Quentin's is not letting me do it. Oh, you did?
Yep, you should have me on the list now.
Okay, perfect. All right. And Stacy, it also wasn't letting me let you in. So are you already in the classroom?
Yes.
Okay, all right, perfect. You guys are too quick for me.
Quentin, who's Aria?
I think Dan, I just got you in. I just got an invitation to you.
My puppy who kept sticking her face in the camera.
Oh, okay.
Thank God for pets.
We like animals.
I like goats.
Did you say goats?
Yes.
You ever been to goat yoga?
No, I haven't. Why? What is that?
Oh, my gosh. All right. Well, we'll have to bring up a little goat yoga thing, and you can see it. Like, goats, baby goats, like, jump all over you while you're doing yoga.
Oh, my God. I love it. I've had 9 goats. I love them.
Stacy's in.
They are the best pet ever.
You'll have to Google the words goat yoga, and you'll see.
I'm writing that down right now.
They have a farm that does it here on Aquidneck Island, and it's awesome.
Goat yoga?
Wow, I've never heard of it.
What?
Yeah, never.
Like, it's therapeutic. Baby goats, jump all over people while they're doing yoga.
Really?
It's a real thing. Mm-hmm.
Okay. All right, I'll take your word for it. I'll be open-minded. Quentin... I'm just looking to see who's in the classroom. Jolene is in the classroom.
Yay!
That's it.
So when I sent my 3 little words here, did you receive them?
Did you send them to the cloud?
I sent them over here on the other side to everyone.
The chat?
Let's see.
I don't see a chat from you, Jolene.
What am I doing? I'm on chat.
Yep.
It says to everyone. I pushed everyone, right?
Yep. And then you type the message underneath and you hit return.
No, wait a minute. What do you mean return? It says send to chat, everyone. No, mine just says file on... Wait a minute. Return. Where do you see? Where's return?
No, once underneath the 2 where everyone is, if you type your message and then you hit return, you hit the enter button, it should send the message to everybody.
Oh, gotcha. Okay.
Try it out.
Okay.
I'm not getting anything.
Yeah, once you type your message, then just on your keyboard hit enter.
Okay. Yeah, how come it's not?
Let me see if I can. I see you in there, so I'm going to type hello to you. So see if you can respond to me, Jolene.
Type message here.
Anger, frustration, confusion.
Got it.
There you go. Just a little delay. Perfect.
Okay. Yeah, you know, right. That leads me to believe, Jolene, that your system might have a little bit of, I forget what you call it, but it's very slow, it sounds like.
Let me tell you a little something about every computer in this building. And I
preach, Jolene.
That's right. And Trent and Stacy will verify everything I tell you.
I was just going to say, though, the managers actually did tell me ahead of time that if you're going to work from any of the office buildings, to just prepare for a little bit of delay or lag, maybe to just exit and restart the whole thing, because like those, we all know how those computers are. It's not going to be 100%, you know?
There you go.
These here are so slow. I mean, when we go on to log in, I mean, they just spin and spin. Half the time we have to have, like, the house manager, can you punch us in or whatever, because it just takes forever and ever and ever.
I was thinking of either processing or bandwidth problems.
And if a lot of people are on, that could be an issue too. You know, I was just noticing that we were joined by another person, and I'm going to apologize if I mispronounce your name, Dialujo Cisco? Sissoko?
Yes, Dialujo Cisco.
Okay, you say it way better than I do. All right. Is the name that's in there, is that the name that you want to be in there?
That's my name, but I go by D, if that makes it
easier for you. Nope. Okay. That's perfect. I just want to make sure and where do you work, D?
Crossroad.
Oh, nice. Okay. Excellent. Yeah. All right. Excellent. All right. So let's.
Crossroads for Gateway Healthcare, not Crossroads in Providence.
Thank you for the clarification, John.
Thank you.
I have Crossroads on the brain because we're training with them right now. So that's good to know.
Hi, Dee.
Hi. Hi, Yolanda.
Been a while. Sorry.
I know.
That's all right. All right. So we have 12 people who were able to respond to this last question that asks on a scale from 1 to 5. How comfortable you are. The first three questions were about talking about mental health, and the second three questions were talking about alcohol and drug use. And so the way it goes is the big circle at the end is the average, but I'm moving my cursor. Can you guys still see my screen?
Yes.
Okay. So you can see the little bubbles above it. So you can see that one person said 0, one person said 1, 3 people said 2, 4 people said 4, 2 people said 4, and 5 people said 5, right? So, and then it averages. So when we look at the average, right, does anything to be learned from how comfortable we are talking about mental health from family members, clients, to coworkers? And Lori, feel free to jump in.
Well, it's funny that you should be asking this particular question, Tanya, because I'm sitting in on a racial equity type of committee at work, and one of the questions that we asked to a greater group of about 50 people of how comfortable they would be talking about certain things, and it came back that they were much more comfortable talking to like strangers than they would be to talk to their coworkers. So it's just interesting that we've got coworkers down here showing up also on the lower end compared to how they feel as professionals in the field talking to patients and clients.
The clients has the most comfort for both abuse, alcohol and drug abuse mm-hmm. and use and mental health. So we're more comfortable there. The least comfort, as Lori just pointed out, is our coworkers. And then we're less comfort, but more comfortable than talking to coworkers, talking to our families about this. What do you guys attribute these averages to?
You don't want to offend people that you know on a personal level, so it might be more difficult to have those conversations, taking into consideration the reaction of the other individual.
Excellent, right? So the relationship and kind of your relationship to that person. How are your relationships with clients different than your relationships with family members and coworkers?
You're already on a therapeutic level, and me being in the substance abuse field, we're supposed to talk about those things. So over time, you gain comfort just through what you do. But additionally, you're in that position to be of guidance and of help, so that conversation can already be expected. There's a segue opening that door.
Okay. So go ahead. Is that John?
Quentin,
go ahead. Sorry, I didn't see your
That's okay.
Lock light up.
Even being in primarily mental health, our clients are absolutely used to and expect us to ask both about their mental health symptoms and about substance use.
Okay. So it's a sanctioned behavior, right? It's appropriate. And you're comfortable doing it because it's a part of the role that you're playing, right? Because the relationship there is that you're providing guidance and providing support, whereas with family members and coworkers, your relationship might be more kind of equal, and issues of offense and those types of things might be more paramount. Okay. Lori, any other observations that you want to share about this?
I'm sorry, not at the moment. I much rather hear the group.
Okay.
But no, it helps me to know where folks want to concentrate, where their comfort level is. And so, yeah, I really like seeing that they're actually pretty high on the scale. So I'm thinking, what can I offer? They're all so comfortable. I'm probably going to learn more from them.
Nice.
Go
ahead, John.
Yeah. I think sometimes people, depending on your culture, you may be very uncomfortable talking about mental health because there are some culture or ethnic group that just don't believe in mental health. So I think for those people, it'll be very uncomfortable talking to family members, but it'll be comfortable talking to a client or a friend.
Okay, so kind of adding another lens of culture here, right? So our role, our relationship and culture. One thing that I want to point out before I kind of do the review for next week is I want to point out we're doing a lot of work in my institute about recovery safe workplaces. And when I think about recovery, I think specifically about both recovery from addiction and also mental health. And so we might be more comfortable talking to our clients. We might feel a little bit less comfortable, but comfortable enough to address things with family members because, you know, we're connected to them. And even when they don't like us, they still love us. And so, you know, they might tolerate that. But I want to point out that, you know, certainly within the workplace, people can struggle with behavioral health challenges. And because if you think about how much time you spend working with your colleagues, you might be the first person to notice that someone, you know, is displaying some symptoms of depression. And so I want to encourage you, while the content in this curriculum is really intended to build our skills as practitioners, I want to remind you that we're all human beings and that there's an opportunity to really think about, and especially considering this pandemic and the fact that it has had such profound impacts on people in terms of depression and anxiety across all ages, actually, that there might be opportunities also to let people that you're working with know that it's okay not to, not to be 100% feeling great about things, and that it's okay to talk about it, right? To really normalize. Your word cloud really demonstrated to me this really nice, healthy balance between the challenges of mental health and behavioral health, and also some of the opportunities to help people heal and to help people really be functioning in society. And so it's not just with our clients, it's with ourselves, our colleagues, our family members as well. I'm gonna stop sharing my screen
And can I say something?
Yeah, absolutely, Delphine.
Yeah, and there was also that stigma between the employees and the employers when you have that, when you have mental health, where you don't feel comfortable telling to your employer in the fear that they will see you in a different line.
Absolutely. Because of the stigma. You guys had the word stigma. And we also had it in our chat, right? So as we're thinking about this, you know, even when we have a lot of skill to support people, there's still a lot of fear that we can carry around ourselves that can make talking about behavioral health a challenge, right? And so part of what we want to do is to really help normalize this with people, and not just our clients. I would say, you know, including ourselves in that as well, and realizing that there's a hierarchy, maybe not with your colleagues that you spend every day with, but having your supervisor know that you're, you know, you're having a difficult time or something like that, and the fear that it's going to diminish how people look at you. People that you're working with as practitioners have that same concern, that they're going to be less human, less healthy if they admit to addiction or behavioral health issues. And so it's an opportunity for us to really develop that sensitivity. Before I turn things over to Lori, I did just want to make sure that people understood. I just looked, we have a lot of people in the classroom. So I will keep working my way through those. But in case you can't get to the classroom, I want to just make sure that when I send you the email that you understand what it is that is due for next week. Okay, can everybody see my screen? Module one, part two? Mm-hmm. Right, so next week, yes. This is the work that's gonna be due. So the pre-work for this, and I will take out the PDF so that it doesn't kind of make it seem like it's more work than it is. I'll turn it into to handouts. And this one, you're going to be watching a video about what is mental health. And then in this one, I will make the link available. This is a great resource. It's a whole participant manual. But in particular, what I'm interested in having people do is to go to this YouTube video and just clicking on it, and you'll see that it brings you to a video. It's only 14 minutes long, but it's a great video, and it gives you a nice overview of the stages of change model that will provide a nice context as you're starting to move forward. So you're gonna be completing those. When you're done, you'll do a reflection activity that will allow you to answer questions from what Lori talks to you about tonight and the stuff that you're learning for in preparation of next week. And then Lori will post some training materials up here that she'll review. And then I'll remind you at the end of next week's training to complete an evaluation that gives you a chance to say what you knew about different topics before the training and then what you know at the end of them. Okay, so I'm gonna send you out an email with links to all of this just to make it accessible to you, and so that this way everybody will be able to kind of participate in it. And again, if you have any difficulty whatsoever, everybody who responded to this invitation has my email and my office number. You can feel free to reach out to me. Lori's information, she will share that as well. And I'm just wondering if anybody has any questions before I hand it over to our social worker here to kind of launch into this good information. Okay, no questions? All right, excellent. So nice to meet everybody. And if you have colleagues who weren't able to come tonight, please encourage them to reach out to me. I'm happy to work to catch them up. I'm going to stop recording my video now, and then I'm going to make Lori a host, so she'll be able to pick up where I left off, and we'll be able to capture, you know, as much of the classes as possible for anyone who wants to join in week two. And I'll look forward to seeing you guys next week.
Thank you.